So welcome students. So in this question, you're given that the complex number z1 minus 2z2 by 2 minus z1 z2 bar is a unimodular complex number and z2 is not a unimodular complex number. And z1 z2 are two complex numbers. So in if z1 z2 satisfy these two conditions, where does z1 lie? That's the question. Z1 lies on what? What is the locus of z1? These are the different questions that are asked. So how do we do this? It's a basic analytical question. So whenever you have questions based on mod, one thing that you need to remember is mod z whole square is equal to z times z bar. It's a very standard formula on the concept of modulus. So any complex number, mod of any complex number whole square is z into its conjugate. So if you apply this here, so and the second formula that I'm going to use is mod of z1 by z2 can be written as mod z1 by mod z2, right? So these are the two formulas that you have. So here mod of something by something can be written as mod of z1 minus 2z2 divided by mod of 2 minus z1 z2 bar is equal to 1. So let us do the cross multiplication. This implies mod of z1 minus 2z2 is equal to mod of 2 minus z1 z2 bar, right? So let me square it on both sides. Now this is in the form mod of something square, mod of some complex number square. So this can be written as z1 minus 2z2 times z1 minus 2z2 whole bar. So z bar is equal to mod z whole square, whatever is there inside mod, that complex number into its conjugate. So this into its conjugate is equal to 2 minus z1 z2 bar times 2 minus z1 z2 bar whole conjugate. So now let us apply the properties of conjugates. So this implies z1 minus 2z2 times, so the conjugate can be separated, that is z1 bar minus 2 times z2 bar is equal to, so here 2 minus z1 z2 bar times 2 conjugate is 2 itself minus z1 bar z2. So this implies now I do the bracket expansion. So z1 bar is mod z1 whole square minus 2 times z2 z1 bar, 2 times z2 z1 bar minus 2 times z1 z2 bar plus 4 times z2 into z2 bar is mod z2 whole square is equal to 2 into 2 is 4 minus 2 z1 z2 bar minus 2 z1 bar z2 plus z1 into z1 bar mod z1 square into mod z2 square. So do you see some cancellations here? This term and this term are getting cancelled. So this implies mod z1 whole square plus 4 times mod z2 whole square minus 4 minus mod z1 square mod z2 square is equal to 0. So you can very easily factorize this. So from these two, if you take mod z1 square as common, you get 1 minus mod z2 square, 1 minus mod z2 square minus 4 times, in these two terms, if you take 4 as common, you get 1 minus mod z2 whole square is equal to 0. This implies 1 minus mod z2 whole square times mod z1 square minus 4 is equal to 0. So this implies mod z2 square is equal to 1 or mod z1 square is equal to 4. And mod z2 square is obviously not equal to 1, this is given in the question. So this can be neglected. So the other condition is mod z1 square is equal to 4, that is mod z1 is equal to 2. That is, the distance of z1 from the origin should always be equal to 2 units. That is, z1 lies on a circle of radius is equal to 2 units and the center is origin. So that's the answer to this question. Thank you.